This remote manor house sitting on the water's edge behind me might seem like the perfect escape, but there's a greater story here hidden under the waves. Find out exactly what it is and where I am in moments.
Today's house hunter is escaping her small London flat, but is she prepared to take on the great outdoors?
Is this your kind of size of garden you'd like to maintain?
Or would you
need a little help in?
I think I might need a bit of help from a gardener because it's very big.
But inside, she is after a little extra space to fit visiting family.
Can you see yourself sitting in the conservatory?
Yes. I'd like to go in there now, actually.
Yes. Oh, well, let's not waste any time then. Today, I'm in Rutland, England's smallest county, and this is Rutland Water, a reservoir that's also the UK's largest man-made lake. When construction of the lake got underway in the early 70s, it caused massive disruption for local villages and communities, with many having to relocate their homes for the reservoir, which finally opened in 1976. The old hall behind me is all that remains of the village of Middle Hambleton. The rest of it is completely submerged. Today, the Hambleton Peninsula is surrounded on three sides by water, but it does provide some of the most spectacular views across one of the highlights at the heart of this lovely county.
Landlocked Rutland covers an area of just 151 square miles. Its longest distance from north to south is only 18 miles and 17 miles from east to west. In 1974, the county merged with Leicestershire, but independence was restored in 1997. The main focal point is Rutland Water, whose southern bank features the Grade II listed Normanton Church. Scheduled for demolition by the reservoir planners, it was saved after a public outcry and is now a popular venue for newlyweds to tie the knot. Today, the largest reservoir in England is used for more than just water storage. As well as being home to many species of wildlife, the 3,100 acres of expansive water are a big draw for sailors and fishermen alike. Then on land, its perimeter offers 25 miles of track for walking and cycling. To the west of Rutland Water is the county town of Oakham. With its quaint, narrow streets and traditional feel, this is a must-see place for many visitors. Oakham Castle is home to a fine collection of more than 200 horseshoes. Peers of the realm passing through the town must give a horseshoe to the Lord of the Manor, a custom started more than 500 years ago that continues to this day. Outside of the towns, Rutland is marked by acres of stunning countryside, which makes it an ideal rural escape.
There's clearly a lot on offer in this beautiful county, despite its small size. In fact, the local motto is multum in parvo, Latin for much in little. And there's a clue in that when it comes to searching for property in the area. The price of a detached house here in Rutland is around about £321,000. That's £23,000 above the national average. So what about today's buyer? What are they searching for in their little slice of England's smallest county?
Management consultant Siobhan and her six-year-old daughter Eleanor are looking to swap the hustle and bustle of Croydon in South London for a much more tranquil life in Rutland, with a little bit of help from her mother, Jackie.
Croydon's started to become quite run down in the last couple of years. The town centre, a lot of the shops have closed. We also have a very long school run, so we have a 50-minute round trip. And partly the property that we're in at the moment, as beautiful as it is, we've just grown out of it.
A big driver for the move is Eleanor, who's a massive fan of all things wild.
Eleanor adores being outside. She loves climbing trees. Bug collecting is a favourite hobby of hers. Fishing for bits and pieces in ponds, and those experiences are not so readily available in an urban environment.
She's very keen on animals and cats and dogs.
And she'd like a dog, she'd like a Labrador, although she's quite partial to Border Collies, and they need a lot of space.
This move will herald some big changes in how Eleanor and indeed Siobhan currently live their lives. Plans are in place to spend more time working from home, which makes leaving the London base a really positive step.
I think we'll really enjoy having fresh air, having access to wider spaces, being able to get out and do cycling more easily, having access to more outdoor pursuits, things that possibly Eleanor hasn't even tried yet, like doing some more water sports we just can't do around this area. The biggest sacrifice really will be being further away from family.
But Mum Jackie is philosophical about the move.
I shall be sorry that I won't see so much of them, and it won't be so easy to pop in and say hello or for them to pop in and see us. I shall regret that, love. But if that's what you and Eleanor want to do, well, I wish you, you know, all the best, and, and Dad and I will support you, and we'll come and see you, of course, and stay. You'll have to have somewhere where we can stay. Mm.
And despite the heart-wrenching thought that Siobhan will be further away, Jackie has no doubts that this is the right move for both daughter and granddaughter.
Well, I think they'll have a slower pace of life. I think they'll see a little bit more of each other. They'll have less time driving around in the car and more time just being together. They'll have more space, and I think that'll be good for them.
With Rutland being such a small county, Siobhan is happy for us to extend our search across the borders into Lincolnshire or Northamptonshire. I'm catching up with Siobhan and Jackie on the banks of Rutland Water to nail the right criteria for the perfect property.
Jackie, Siobhan, lovely to see you.
Hello.
So tell me, what has brought us to this wonderful corner of the world?
As you can see, it's a beautiful place. Lots of cycling, foraging and tree climbing, all of the things that Eleanor loves to do.
So Jackie, supermom, here to support Siobhan. How well do you know the area?
Well, I've been here several times, been on holidays with my husband, and I know Siobhan's been here as well. And we think it's really nice. It's a nice place to live. It's good for bringing up a family. And I'm retired now. I'm free to visit her, and I shall be doing that. Plenty of that.
What are we searching for in terms of property?
Ideally, a three-bedroom plus house, so that my parents can come and visit and friends can come and stay. Yes. So we've got the built-in childcare, some nice open space, a nice garden, or at least good access straight into lovely walks in the fields and across the countryside.
So when you're talking garden, are we talking postage stamp garden, or are we talking a few acres?
Well, what's the dream? Somewhere in between. Okay. I love gardening, and we need somewhere for the trampoline and maybe some raised beds.
What kind of property are you looking for?
Something with some nice character, but with some, you know, with possibly with some, you know, modernisation. It's got to fit with access to the school and the possible commuting to London. So it's a decision I'm not going to take lightly. I will make sure we make the right decision.
How much are we looking with today?
Ideally, under 450,000. That's our absolute maximum budget. But I'd like to try and keep under that if I could.
Well, we have three fantastic properties for you to see. Let's get searching.
Lovely. Lovely. Thank you.
With a top budget of £450,000, Siobhan and daughter Eleanor are looking to escape their two-bed flat in Croydon in pursuit of a character home with a modern interior, a family kitchen diner, three bedrooms, and a good-sized garden. They'd also like to be close to a village with easy access to local schools. We've found some fantastic properties to tempt them with, and at each one, I'll be asking them to guess the price before I reveal it. The last in our selection will be our mystery house, which may challenge Siobhan's expectations when it comes to character, but could put her young daughter right in her element.
So tell me a little more about what you love about this area.
It's just a great part of the country to live in and to raise a family. It's a slower pace of life.
As Siobhan doesn't mind us extending our search into Rutland's borderlands, Baston Village in Lincolnshire is our first stop. At the centre is the village green, flanked by a local church with parts of the building dating back to the 12th century. Close by is a general store and post office. There's a real community feel here, with a village hall complete with children's playground and sports facilities. Six-year-old Eleanor will be spoilt for choice when it comes to her education, as both state and independent schools can be found in the village. And with our first property just a few minutes' drive away, those long school runs could be a thing of the past.
Welcome to Property One, your 1800 mill owner's cottage.
Well,
wow, it's beautiful.
This was where the mill workers would come and stay. Uh-huh. This section of the cottage was built in 1800, and all this, which could also be yours, was added in 2005.
Gosh.
Huge. Really
yes.
big.
Yes, it is. It is.
And very tastefully done. You can't necessarily notice straight away the difference in the brickwork.
This early 19th century millworker's cottage offers nearly 2,200 square feet of generous living space. On the ground floor are three sitting rooms, and that 2005 extension added yet more accommodation space. We're entering through the front door, which takes us directly into a cosy snug.
So here we are in the original part of the cottage. You've got your lovely snug and the fireplace to welcome you.
It's lovely.
It's
very
charming.
Warm and inviting. Very good so far.
And this is just the start. So much to see.
Yes.
Also on this floor, there's a small study and a good-sized double bedroom, ideal for when Jackie visits. Crossing the dining room, we find what for many is the heart of the home.
Into your nice, spacious kitchen, which looks out onto your new conservatory. That was added to the property in about 2010, the latest bit of work that the owners did. And you pass your lovely dining space.
Yes, it's beautiful.
As we came through into the kitchen. What do you think?
It's lovely. It's really big.
It is.
And beautifully light, because it leads straight onto the conservatory and gorgeous views of the garden. Yes,
it is.
I mean,
it is.
It's a beautiful
yes.
space.
Yes. I must say, the conservatory looks good, doesn't it? The space it gives you here, from here.
I know that's something you really love, isn't it? Light and airy, and a period property can be a little bit dark, or there's
yes,
the compromise between
the
dark and cosy, isn't there?
Yes, absolutely. And the good thing is, Eleanor can sit and help prepare, or while she's doing her homework, I can cook, which is something we can't do at the moment.
Yes, this would work better.
So can you see yourself sitting in the conservatory?
Yes. I'd like to go in there now, actually. Yes.
Oh, well, let's not waste any time then. Jackie, this way, come on.
Come.
This house does have a lovely flow. Walking through the conservatory, we come into the main sitting room.
Gosh.
Wow. So what do you think about this in terms of a living space?
Oh, it's a perfect space.
Lovely.
It's not too big. It's certainly not too small. And you still get that cosy feel.
Mm-hmm. But the light flooding through as well.
Yes. Lovely.
Yes.
So could you imagine some nice evenings chatting about what you and Eleanor have done in the day, or
Absolutely.
The walks you've been on?
Yes. Yeah, completely.
I'm just wondering where the bathroom is and things like that.
I will let you explore everything.
It's always a step ahead.
But I'd like to show you the bedrooms upstairs first.
Okay, yes, that's
so
fine.
Let's go and have a look at those three.
Lovely.
Yes. And then you can come down and you
and,
want to
and
check out your wing. That's what it
that's
is, isn't it?
Yeah.
You're moving
She's
bits and pieces.
Plans.
I like your style. Come this
let's
way.
Go.
Heading upstairs to the first floor, there's a generous landing. To one side, doors lead to two double bedrooms, both with ample storage and situated next to the fully tiled family bathroom. Next for us is the master.
And into what could be your main bedroom.
Wow, it's lovely.
Which doesn't have an ensuite, but it has a bathroom just next door, which could be yours. And there's a room off that, which is currently used as a little bedroom when the lady's granddaughter comes to stay. But it could become a dressing room for you, or maybe a little office as well. So what do you think about this size of room? Good for you?
Oh, yes.
It's fine, isn't it?
Yeah, more than big enough. Absolutely.
And you've got lots of storage space, which I know you love.
Yes, it's beautiful.
And a lovely window.
Yeah, all the light
Looking
flooding
out,
through.
Aren't you? Yeah.
It's a beautiful property.
It is nice, beautifully done. Mm.
Well, of course, we have to talk about price, which we'll do in the garden, and there is a beautiful garden to show you. So much more still to see.
Right, yes.
The house is positioned on a good-sized plot, which includes a very attractive gravelled patio area. The gravel theme continues around the side of the property with a spacious driveway and a separate double garage. At the back, there's a feature pond, well-established fruit trees, shrubs, and a generous lawn, all of which should make an ideal adventure playground for Siobhan's daughter, Eleanor.
Siobhan, you said you wanted a garden somewhere between postage stamp and a few acres. Have we hit the mark here?
Oh, almost certainly. I mean, it's beautiful.
It is lovely.
It's incredible. All you can hear, it's so tranquil. You can just hear the birds, you see the bees, and the garden itself is stunning.
This garden has apple trees,
yes.
Pear trees, you've got blackberries, raspberries at the end of the garden.
As well as a trampoline.
That's kind of Eleanor-sized trampoline. There's a lot of fun to be had on that, I think. Is this your kind of size of garden you'd like to maintain?
Or would you
need a little help here?
I think I might need a bit of help from a gardener because it's very big, isn't it? Much bigger than I expected that
we'd
be able to get.
Two or three times.
Yes.
So time now to take the garden and the house into consideration. For this particular property, what do you think the current market price is?
I'm going to say 45.
Jackie, what do you think?
I'm going to go for 430.
Well, Jackie, at £430,000, you are closer to the price of this property.
Right.
This property with this gorgeous garden is currently on the market for £450,000.
Oh, it's top.
So that's the top of your budget.
Yes. Mm. Should have guessed that, shouldn't we, really? Mm, mm. Given how big it is.
Yes.
Well, there is a lot of house to explore. Mm. Why don't I let you go and
really take
a look at all those bedrooms and all the rooms available to you, and we'll catch up in a bit.
Lovely.
Thank you.
Right on budget at £450,000, this beautiful character home has large entertaining areas, four double bedrooms, and a spacious garden for that dog that Eleanor is so keen to have.
I think Eleanor would adore this property. The only thing she might miss out on is having neighbours and children in neighbouring properties that she could play with, which is something that we would like when we have our move to the country.
I think the house is rather isolated from the local community. I believe it's about a mile from the nearest village, and, you know, I do feel that's a bit far.
Hello, ladies. Have you had a good look round everything now?
We have.
Fantastic. Like what you've seen?
It's beautiful.
Great. Good start. Property one. Let's go explore property two.
Great. Wonderful. Let's go.
Rutland and the surrounding area has long been a favourite for would-be country escapees. The impressive architecture, including stately homes and castles, is just one of many reasons Siobhan adores this part of the country. So we've arranged for her and Jackie to meet head guide David Shipton, who's going to tell them more about one of the area's grandest buildings, Rockingham Castle.
The first castle was built here by William the Conqueror around 1070, and that grew into a huge stone castle. You're standing in front of these wonderful drum towers built by Edward I in the 1270s. It was then a royal castle till the reign of Henry VIII. He was the last king to visit here.
So when was that?
That was in 1540, when he came here with Catherine Howard, about a year before he cut her head off.
Oh, right. What happened after that? Who did he give the castle to?
The castle by then was very dilapidated. The king hadn't been spending money maintaining it, and it was falling down in places. And along comes a man called Edward Watson, and he rented the castle from Henry VIII and gradually began to turn it into a family home.
Today, Edward Watson's legacy lives on. And the castle is now owned and maintained by his descendant, and much of the original renovation work carried out over subsequent years still exists.
This is the Long Gallery, which was completed in about the reign of Charles I. It was a superb room in which the family could come and take their leisure when the weather was inclement, where they could show off the family portraits.
Yes.
And it's a room which really came alive, though, again, in the 19th century, when Richard and Lavinia Watson lived here. They were great friends of Charles Dickens.
Oh.
And he came here on several occasions, and he put on plays in other rooms and in this room.
Beneath the lavish Venetian chandeliers, flock wallpaper, and luxurious drapes, Dickens performed some of his most recognized works and wasn't averse to treading the boards himself.
In this cabinet, we've collected various objects to do with Dickens. This is the actual playbill for the plays that he put on in this room on January the 18th, 1851. As you can see, he starred in them. He played the lead role in all three plays.
Sir Charles Coldstream. Oh, yes. Yeah. A day after the wedding. Quite saucy, I should think.
But I wasn't here, so I don't know. It could be. We also have early copies of Bleak House, a novel which he wrote in which features a great house called Chesney Wold. And many of the features of that great house are based on Rockingham. So the long gallery you're in becomes the long drawing room.
Rockingham Castle's extraordinary heritage seems to know no bounds. The Great Hall has played host to some very distinguished guests.
So, David, what would the room have been used for?
We know that when the kings came here, they lived here. There was a king's chamber off the end. They would have dined here. And many of the people would have actually slept around the room when it came to nighttime.
Many of the objects here date back to the mid-17th century, including artifacts from the English Civil War.
And if you would like to see what you would look like as a cavalryman from the English Civil War, so would you like to try it on?
Which side would have worn this then, David?
Both parliamentarians and royalists wore much the same sort of helmets. Heavy?
It's very heavy.
It's heavy. It's got to protect you from sword cuts and other nasty things.
What else might they have worn to protect their bodies?
You would also have worn a breastplate and a backplate. And also gauntlets like this on your wrists.
It's so incredibly heavy. You just wonder how anybody could fight a good battle so weighed down.
The hands of restoration can also be seen beyond the castle walls. Outside, 18 acres of gardens surround the main house and boast an unmissable feature.
Can you tell us something about that strange hedge?
Well, this hedge, which is 400 years old, a yew hedge. We call it the elephant hedge.
That looks a little bit like one, doesn't it, that one there?
When we have school children visit, we say, can you see any animals? And nearly always, some of them will identify them as elephants.
Thanks so much. We have enjoyed it.
Good. Let's hope we can find Siobhan her own Rutland pile as we get back to our property search. Our second house is located in the Rutland village of Ridlington, just a couple of miles from the market town of Uppingham. With its pretty streets, traditional shops and attractive square overlooked by the 14th century church, Uppingham is one of the most picturesque towns in the county of Rutland. There should be everything here that Siobhan and Eleanor could hope for, including primary and secondary schools, one of which was established back in 1584. And the house we've come to see is within easy reach of all these amenities, back in the village of Ridlington.
So, ladies, property number 2, 4-bed, lovely, spacious house, built in the early 70s, updated just before the millennium, and more recently by the current owners.
Right.
Initial thoughts?
Modern.
Very, very modern.
Large.
Again, a beautiful, tranquil setting.
Nice.
Shall we get inside?
Yes.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Come this way.
Just 4 decades old, this is a much more modern affair than our first house. But I'm hopeful the central village location has got us off to a good start. The front entrance takes us straight into the main living portion of the property.
So into your rather large kitchen diner.
Wow, it's beautiful.
It is spacious, isn't it?
Off the main kitchen,
yes,
you've got a lovely laundry room.
Mm-hmm.
The owners turned the current garage behind into a sort of study come storage area.
Mm-hmm.
Diner behind you. There's also a little snug off the kitchen, which Eleanor could do homework in or set up a little computer room or you could make into an office.
This is a lovely family space.
It is.
Beautiful.
It is. And do you like having that separate dining area?
Oh, yes, I think that's right.
Yes, I think that's really nice.
Yes.
And the light coming through from the garden is beautiful.
It is, isn't it?
Mm.
It is.
Very warm.
It's just the right place.
Let me show you the living room before we head upstairs.
Lovely.
And from the kitchen diner into your living room, which opens out onto the garden. Would this space work for you?
I think it's a good family room. It's a good size. I like the window here and the light
the
coming
light.
In. I'm not sure if it's to Siobhan's taste, though.
I mean, I like it. It's quite modern.
OK. Well, still lots more to see.
Yes.
Lovely. Okay.
I'm getting the feeling this style of house may not be working for Siobhan, but I hope the bright landing upstairs with great views over the surrounding countryside boosts her enthusiasm. Up here, there's a bright single and two double bedrooms, all of which are served by a modern family bathroom. Lastly, we find the largest room on this floor.
And into the master bedroom with en suite. Oh,
very large room.
It is, isn't it? It's huge for a master bedroom.
This was the part of the house that the owner, the current owners, extended, and they built the extra space and then yes. the en suite. That's what they've added most recently.
Okay, yes.
And it's so tranquil.
It is.
Peaceful night's sleep.
Absolutely.
Gorgeous view to wake up to.
An amazing amount of storage as well, with the built-in wardrobes.
Of course, the garden to explore as well.
Oh, yes.
And then we've got to talk about price.
Right.
Outside, I'm hoping we're onto a winner with a low-maintenance, manageable garden. To the rear, sliding doors from the dining and sitting room lead to a patio area, flanked by hedges and established planting. A beautiful lawn extends to a summer house for those long, lazy summer evenings.
A really good size and beautiful as well. Lots of mature shrubs, beautiful summer house and evening sun. It's delightful.
And do you think it would work for Eleanor? Would she approve?
Oh, I do think she'd approve, yes. It's a lovely garden.
Well, you've seen the garden, you've taken a look at the house. Mm-hmm. Time to talk about money. How much do you think this property is on the market for?
I'm going to say £410,000.
I'll say
£445,000, £410,000.
Yes. Quite a difference.
Indeed. Well, this property is currently on the market for £439,950.
Oh, I was way out. You were nearer. Mm.
So it gives you a little wiggle room in that budget still.
That's
and
great.
And a lot of property for your money again.
Oh, absolutely. So much space.
Well, now you know the price. Mm-hmm. Why don't you have a bit more of an explore and we'll catch up in a bit.
Lovely. Thanks. Thank you.
Coming in around £10,000 under budget, this modern house gives high returns for the money, with a great kitchen diner, four bedrooms, a manageable garden, and a central village location.
I think it's a very large house. I think it's very modern. And from that point of view, I think it's probably too modern for Siobhan. But I must say that it's a very good family house.
I love the size of the property. It's beautiful, it's a great location. On reflection, I do think that possibly it's a bit too big for myself and for Eleanor. The garden is lovely. I could really see us enjoying the space. But it's probably also too modern for us.
How are you?
Fine, thanks.
You've had a good scoot right across the house.
We have.
Well, that's it for day one of our property search. Mystery house tomorrow.
Excited.
What have you got in store for us?
You'll have to wait and see. Homeward bound now, though.
Siobhan, with the help of her mum, Jackie, is looking to escape her Croydon-based two-bed flat in South London with her six-year-old daughter, Eleanor. They're looking for a more peaceful life in Rutland with a top budget of £450,000. Still to come, we've got the Mystery House, which offers country living with a twist of retro styling.
So out of your Mystery House to a mystery feature.
It's sensational. It's beautiful.
And I'll be switching my attention from house hunting to the open water for a very different kind of search.
We've got it!
I was sure property one yesterday was going to be a winner with that fabulous garden, but it didn't quite have the village location that Siobhan's searching for. And property two had the village, but the house itself didn't have quite enough character for Siobhan. So where does that leave us with the mystery house? Well, it's in the heart of a village and it certainly has a unique character, but will it be the one to tempt Siobhan to make the move? Let's find out. So how are you feeling about the mystery house today?
Possibly a new build, because I hadn't completely ruled them out. Or I suppose it could be a new build with character, because there's quite a few properties that are around that are newer, but are done so sympathetically.
destination is the Northamptonshire village of Kingscliff, around 5 miles from the Rutland County border. But before we get to our mystery house, we're taking a pit stop in the village to show our ladies all that Kingscliff can offer.
Siobhan, Jackie, you might be wondering why I've brought you here. Well, this is the village of Kingscliff, and it's the village that's home to our mystery house. Ooh. Local parish church is behind you, All Saints and St James's, and the village has all the amenities that you were searching for. That local village shop, pop out for that pint of milk, you've got a village pub, doctor's surgery, baker's, village store, and a local school 5 minutes from the front door of the mystery house.
Sounds lovely.
Your village and the mystery house are just 20 minutes from Rutland Water, which I know you really wanted to explore with Eleanor.
It's a delightful village.
It's beautiful. The architecture, the properties, the church.
It's got a lovely atmosphere.
We can't wait to see the mystery house.
Well, let's not waste any time.
Come on,
head this way.
Our architect-designed mystery house is just a stone's throw from the village centre.
Designed by the architect, Lionel Ebrey, who's also designed two other properties in the village. It's detached, four-bed, originally built in 1971 and extended in 1980.
Very unusual.
It is.
OK, let's get in and see more.
OK.
The entrance takes us to a hallway that leads through into the main sitting room, which is full of vintage character, albeit 1970s style.
So here we are, into your split-level living space. Room for a dining room, you've got your wood burner there, which I know you really like, and then some extra space. You could put a desk up there if you wanted, a little bit of work late night, or a desk for Eleanor as well. What strikes you about this room?
Strange.
It's quite unusual. Just the style of the property and the windows. I don't really like metal frames particularly. Obviously, those can be changed.
Well, there's more of the house to see.
Great. Yes.
Let's head into the kitchen.
Lovely. Yes.
Heading out of the main living area, we pass through a utility and boot room and on into the kitchen.
Lovely space.
Like the size of this?
Yes. Yes, I do.
It's perfect for family living, this space as well.
And can you see Siobhan and Eleanor living in here the more you look round?
I'm not sure about that.
Well, there is one special feature that I really want to show you that I think Eleanor in particular will love. Come this way.
Okay. Also on this floor is a snug or formal dining room and a small cloakroom. Up on the first floor are four double bedrooms.
Another nice room.
One of which is being used as an office. The generous, bright, airy master comes with its own ensuite. There's also a large modern family bathroom with a separate shower cubicle. As we head outside, it's clear that this house is not quite what Siobhan is looking for, but she's yet to see the real highlight here, which is just outside the living room.
So out of your mystery house, to a mystery feature, the beautiful babbling brook at the edge of your property.
It's sensational. It's beautiful, really.
It's really lovely.
You really do have Mother Nature on your doorstep here.
I really can see Eleanor just sitting on the steps, feeding the ducks.
Jumping in.
Oh, yes, potentially jumping in.
It's really lovely.
It is.
I see there's somewhere for me to sit too, I think. Yes.
You've got a little space there, table and chairs, glass of wine at the end of the day.
Suit me.
Catch the sun.
Who has a brook at the end of the garden? Mm. It's not very every day, is it?
Siobhan seems enthusiastic about this special garden feature, as it could be an ideal environment for wildlife fan Eleanor. And what's on offer outside doesn't stop here. To the rear of the property is a large patio and a substantial lawned area bordered with a stone wall. Mature trees and shrubs pepper the garden, completing the grounds of this one-off mystery house.
The more you've had a look round, have your views on it changed?
It's really grown on me, actually, to come out into the garden area and to have the brook at the end of the garden. I could really see Eleanor and I enjoying this space.
Time to talk about price. What do you think this mystery house with its babbling brook is on the market for?
It's got to be above my upper limit, so I would say £460,000.
Jackie, how much do you think the house is on the market for?
Well, I'm going to say it's £450,000.
The mystery house is currently on the market for £450,000.
Oh!
Jackie, spot you are spot on. Well, now you know the price. Why don't you have a look around once more? And then we've got some talking to do.
Okay.
So we love the location, the babbling brook, the gardens, but perhaps the unique design, just a step too far.
This architect-designed house comes in bang on budget and would certainly offer Siobhan and daughter Eleanor a different style of living. With its generous open-plan ground floor, four good-sized bedrooms, a beautiful garden complete with babbling brook, and a central village location, this property offers the right buyer a perfect country escape. But has it been enough to inspire Siobhan?
Lovely, isn't it?
A really nice room.
Good size. Mum and I have very similar tastes. We both like character properties. It's just not the style and the age of property and design that we particularly like, and I don't think Mum would think that this is the right property for us.
Siobhan's attracted to the garden and to the brook at the bottom and the possibilities of enjoying the wildlife and the countryside. But as for the house itself, I think she feels that it's not to her taste, and that means that she wouldn't feel completely comfortable.
Hello. You had a good explore around the mystery house.
We have.
Great. Shall we find somewhere lovely for a cuppa and a good chat?
Sounds yes. good.
Lots to talk about. Come on.
Rutland may be the smallest county in the UK, but it certainly lives up to its local motto, much in little. And nowhere else is this more apparent than on Rutland Water, a big attraction for wildlife and water sports enthusiasts. But it's fly fishing that's found particular renown in recent years. To find out more about why, I've come to meet Rob Waddington. Hopefully, he's going to help me land my first fish.
Rob, great to see
Hi,
you.
Hi, welcome. Welcome to my shed on the banks of Rutland Water.
So how long have you been fly fishing here?
I've been fishing here for 20 years, but I've been fly fishing a bit longer than that.
21.
Yeah, maybe.
What makes fishing, fly fishing on Rutland Water so special?
Rutland Water here is probably one of the best fly fishing lakes in the UK, and it's for two reasons, really. The size of the place, it's huge out there. It's the biggest man-made lake in Western Europe. We've got about 26 miles of shoreline and about 3,500 acres of water. It's massive, yeah.
Today, we're going to be targeting the Rutland trout. And to attract these local beauties, Rob uses an artificial fly as bait.
At the moment, the fish are feeding heavily on the natural insects. So we're going to imitate some tiny little midges that you perhaps saw as you toured the lake. Yeah, we're going to use these tiny little things here.
Oh, that is small, wow.
Yeah. Well, these tiny little things here. And we find that if we use the more natural, imitative flies, that we do catch the better fish.
Before Rob will let me loose on the lake, I need a crash course in how to cast.
Right, up.
Back.
Back.
A bit sharp.
That's
forward. Real sharp.
Real sharp.
Bang. Lovely. Back and forward. Get it snapping sharp. Tick-tock. Tick-tock. Release. Into the distance. Next one. Tick, tock, release. We've got it!
Oh! I love it! Was it sort of 5 out of 10 or?
Pretty good. I think we stand a good chance of catching a fish there.
Maybe even enough to get out on the water.
With rod and fly in hand, we head for the open water. At nearly 100 feet deep in places, there's ample space for species like perch, pike, zander and carp to happily thrive. But the trout are stocked from outside, so there's no danger of destroying breeding pairs. Anglers can fish for their supper, but if I'm lucky, I'll be putting my catch back to fight another day.
Good day for it. So your line's
out. Oh, it's gone down.
Pull it up.
Stop. Missed it.
Oh.
It's definitely feeling like my lucky day. A few minutes later and...
Oh, you got a fish! Got a fish! OK, start reeling. Oh, let it take line.
Let it out a little bit, OK.
No, reel it again.
Reel it in, yeah.
Just raise the rod now.
Raise the rod.
And we've got it! We've got a lovely fish!
Thanks, coach!
Well done.
What have I got?
You've got a lovely Rutland rainbow trout. Well done.
Proud of you.
Rob, it's been a joy to learn about fishing. Thank you so much. Do we let this little fella or big fella back in now?
What a great end to the day. But it remains to be seen if we've made the perfect catch when it comes to houses.
I'm sensing we haven't quite found Siobhan, the property of her dreams. But now she's had a chance to think about all three. Let's see how she's feeling. So, big question, what's next?
It's given us a lot to think about, hasn't it?
Yes, it has. It has indeed.
I still love Rutland as a county, and they have some beautiful properties that we'd like to explore and look around a little bit more. But I think I'm also going to widen my search to include some of the areas that we've looked at, particularly for property number three, the mystery property, the mystery house. The village was so beautiful.
That was in such a lovely village. It really was.
So you really took to Kingscliff.
Oh, it
absolutely.
Was lovely.
It really showed us that we need to look across the county boundary and explore some of those smaller villages and even possibly some of the smaller towns.
So has the search helped crystallise for you the type of property you're searching for?
I really feel that now I'm looking for something with... you know, more original features, a nice fireplace, possibly some nooks and crannies like we saw in property one.
Something a bit more traditional, Siobhan.
Something a bit more traditional.
Mm. Well, listen, we wish you well. It's been a joy to search with you over these last few days. And do let us know what decision you and little Eleanor finally make.
Thank you. It's been enormously helpful.
Well, our search has definitely confirmed for Siobhan that Rutland and the surrounding areas are the place she wants to search for that new home for herself and her little girl, Eleanor. And finding a village that she can be right at the heart of is essential to that search. I hope it won't be too long before we're hearing from Siobhan that she has found that dream property. And I'll see you next time on Escape to the Country.
If you would like to escape to the country in England, Northern Ireland, Wales or Scotland and need our help, you can apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.